Hi everyone, it's Milfia, and welcome for a new video! Today, we're going to theorize about whether Hytale will be a free-to-play or a pay-to-play kind of game. First of all, just note that we're only going to discuss these two business models because in our opinion, models like a subscription is kind of an old model and we barely see it in games nowadays. Free-to-play and pay-to-play are two very different models. What does a pay-to-play game consist of? It's the traditional business model for video games. You buy the game and access all the features at once, or at least most of it. It's a model that requires a lot of commercial resources. The biggest number of sales is happening on day one, so there's a need for a lot of advertisement and hype around the game. What does a free-to-play game consist of? It's a newer business model for video games. You have free access to the game but are required to pay for some perks or to get some content. It's the most lucrative model as of today in the video games business. You get a more frequent content. The game will be focused on the servers, where the players will pay to have access to rank and perks. Of course, not every player is going to pay, but the aim is to get as many players as possible in hope to have players who are willing to invest a lot of money in the game. Why would Hytale choose the free-to-play path? It's important to note that Hytale originates from Hypixel Studios, the team of the Hypixel server. A free-to-play server that helped them get a lot of data. A whole lot of data! Why are the players paying? How are they paying? What sales or offers are more lucrative? All that data is very important for every free-to-play creator. And as they already announced that there will be minigames servers like the one which made them famous, it will be logical that they continue that way. In a Q&A available on their website, they mentioned that the progression will not be transferable from the adventure mode to the servers. So, we can imagine a progression system on the servers also. At the beginning of the creation of Hytale, the team went to see Riot Games to ask for some advice. Now, Riot Games bought Hytale. Riot Games, the ones that made League of Legends the third most profitable free-to-play in the world. At least, we can think that the servers will be free-to-play. But what if the servers are free-to-play and the adventure mode is pay-to-play? Why would Hytale choose the pay-to-play path? Like Minecraft, you have to buy the license and then gain free access to the servers. As Minecraft is one of their main references, it would be logical that they choose this path too. So, the game will be pay-to-play, with access to the adventure mode and to the servers, which will be free-to-play, but with content that you will have to pay for to unlock. For the pay-to-play model, the game needs a very strong communication at launch to make the maximum of sales. Once it's launched, they can add DLC that players will have to buy or other content punctually. This content will need to be important so that players won't get bored. As for the free-to-play, this content needs to be more frequent, weekly or monthly. It needs to be often renewed. They announced that the game will be followed by the team after its release, so we know we'll get new content, we just don't know the frequency it will have. The free-to-play model is the best way for the team to get money from the game in the long term. However, we need to take in consideration that they only announced a PC release for now, and the best platform for free-to-play is mobile. Choosing if your game is going to be a free-to-play or a pay-to-play is not a last-minute decision. Let's take the example of Overwatch. They developed the whole game as a free-to-play, but nearing the end, they realized that in a FPS game, players cannot see their characters, and as the whole modelization was based on cosmetics, it would be difficult for them to make a real profit with the game model as such. But keep in mind that Blizzard is a big studio, really strong, and they know what they're doing. We can see frequent updates on their game, as it would be for free-to-play. Cosmetics are available as for free-to-play. They could have done a champion rotation, like League of Legends or Heroes of the Storm, their previous game. As we said, it's not a small decision to make, and we're pretty sure that the Hytale team already knows what path they will choose. In another Q&A from December 2018, they answered the question, is Hytale going to be a free-to-play or paid? With, we're still finalizing the exact details of the business model. When that's done, we'll share more details! In our opinion, it's a bit more complicated than that. We think that they already know that the servers will be following the free-to-play model, but their questioning is around the adventure mode. Will they make it available for free because they know they can make money thanks to the servers, or will they make that part pay-to-play? As I said, they gave this answer in December 2018, and we still have no real answer to this day. For us, the option they'll choose is to make the adventure mode a pay-to-play like Minecraft. On the launcher, it will be very easy for them to make a button to access directly the official server and be sure to have a big number of players on it. This probability will reassure the community, because some are afraid that if the game is free to play, there will be a lot of children, a lot of misbehaving, and no real way to penalize bad behavior. Another fear that arose in the community is the overload of the servers. About that, we have to take in consideration that it's not easy for anyone to prevent overload. Guild Wars 2, a pay-to-play with a team specialized on online game, had technical difficulties the day of the launch. So, whatever business model they will choose, there is no way to be sure that the servers will be able to handle it at the launch. This is reinforced by the hype generated by the trailer that nobody on their team even wished for. Minecraft's players are mostly around 10 to 12 years old, but those players are for the most part on mobile and console. Hytale will be released on PC first, and the target age for those are between 16 and 30 years old. So, we shouldn't fear the maturity of the community too much for now. In conclusion, there are two main business models the Hytale team could choose from, pay-to-play or free-to-play. And we expect a pay-to-play for the adventure mode like Minecraft, and a free-to-play for the server available after buying the adventure mode. But, as we said, this is our theory, the developers of the game are the one who knows the truth, and we have to trust them, they already showed us that they know what they're doing. I hope you enjoyed this video! Don't hesitate to tell us what you think of our theories and what are your theories in the comments and on Discord. Here is another video you can watch to learn more about Hytale's beta. So, it was Milfia, and I'll see you soon on Hytale Up!